The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a Sabbath, Jesus went to dine at the home of one of the leading Pharisees. He said to the host who invited him, "When you hold a lunch or a dinner, do not invite your friends or your brothers or sisters or your relatives or your wealthy neighbors, in case they may invite you back and you have repayment. Rather, when you hold a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, the blind. Blessed indeed will you be because of their inability to repay you, for you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. Pakibati ng magandang umaga ang ating mga kasama ngayong Monday morning. To our online parishioners, thank you for praying with us today. The memorial of St. Charles Borromeo. And I'm a bit biased today because St. Charles is the seminary where I graduated. Ako po'y pumasok ng seminaryo ng San Carlos ng 1989 at naging pari sa seminaryo din ng San Carlos sa Makati noong ng 1999. So in a way, I spent almost all of my life in San Carlos Seminary, beginning as a seminarian and then as a formator. I was also a teacher, professor, and formator in the same seminary for around 10 years. So practically 20 years of my life were spent inside the halls and campus of St. Charles Borromeo. And one thing that all our mentors in the seminary somehow emphasize and focus in terms of formation according to Charles Borromeo is the path of holiness and humility. The motto of Charles Borromeo was humilitas, that always and everywhere you do everything in humility. In other words, there's nothing you should be proud of except that you are given this great gift of vocation to serve. Anything that you do, always do it so that it becomes a work of love. Yun po yung laging inuulit ni St. Charles Borromeo. He was a great reformer of the church in the 16th century. There was, of course, a problem in terms of reformation of Martin Luther in the 16th century. And Charles Borromeo, together with Ignatius of Loyola, Philip Neri, and the others, they led those who were loyal to the church to a counter-reformation. Charles Borromeo is what we may call a Nepo baby. Sa ngayon, usong-uso yung Nepo baby. Ano yung Nepo baby? Ito yung mga privileged children of famous people na ginagamit yung fame ng kanilang mga magulang para sa kanilang advantage. In one way or another, we may say that Charles Borromeo was the original Nepo baby. Nepo, short for nepotism. But in a good way, because Charles Borromeo was born to a noble family in Lombardy, in Italy. He was part of the Medici family, the ruling class at that time. Mayaman sila, ma-impluensya at makapangyarihan. And in fact, his uncle became a pope, Pope Pius IV. And when he became pope, he called on Charles Borromeo to be with him and become his secretary. Kaya bata pa lang si San Carlos Borromeo, he became a bishop. In fact, he was called a baby bishop. He was made a bishop 27 years old. And he became a leading figure in the Counter-Reformation, especially in the convocation of the Council of Trent. The Council of Trent reformed the church in order to respond to the Protestantism which was raging at that time. Charles Borromeo, in spite of his noble background, but he chose to live in austerity, in simplicity and humility. The year 1576 was the defining moment for Charles Borromeo. He was born 1538, died 46 years old in 1584. But in 1576, he was the Archbishop of Milan. There was a great plague which was named after him, the Plague of Charles Borromeo, because that plague killed thousands of people in Italy at that time. The governor, the noble people, the noble families, they went out of Milan. Only one figure was left, Charles Borromeo, the Archbishop. There was a raging plague, but he was with his people. Hindi niya iniwanan yung mga tao, pinaglingkuran niya ang lahat. He was feeding 60,000, 70,000 people every day during the plague. Nagkautang-utang siya, ginastos niya lahat ng kayamanan ng pamilya niya para sa pagtulong sa nangangailangan. That's why Pope Benedict XVI calls him his life as Lumen Caritatis, the light of charity. Because the life of this nobleman was a life lived in service and charity and humility. At tamang-tama sa kanya yung ebanghelyo natin ngayon, na pag nag-iimbita kayo ng mga papakainin nyo sa inyong piging, huwag nyong imbitahin yung mga taong makababayad at makababalik sa'yo. Imbitahin mo yung mga walang kakayanan na bayaran ka sa ginawa mo. That was Charles Borromeo. He gave everything. He gave up his right for power. Nung namatay ang kanyang kapatid na si Federico, ginagawa siyang head of the family of Medici, at least in their area. But he renounced it and he wanted to become a simple bishop taking care of his flock. Charles Borromeo would often say, "May all that we do become a work of love. Sana lahat ng gagawin natin araw-araw maging gawain ng pag-ibig sa kapwa." I have many more to tell you about Charles Borromeo, but suffice it to say that this great saint has done so much for the church, especially in the Counter-Reformation. Without the reform of Charles Borromeo, we would not have seminaries. Charles Borromeo initiated that all who would like to be ordained as priests must undergo a certain kind of seminary formation. Hindi pwedeng maging pari dahil lang gusto niya. Kailangang hubugin siya para siya'y maging handa sa paglilingkod. At kanyang ginabayan din ng simbahan sa panahon na tayo ay nalilito din kung sino ba ang mamumuno at paano ba natin ipapahayag ang mabuting balita. Charles Borromeo is the patron saint of catechists, evangelizers, and those who are involved in preaching the gospel. Because for him, we can only win souls by way of service, charity. We can win souls through our own prayers and penance. Souls can be won on one's knees in prayer, he would often say. So I invite you, no? As I've told you, I'm quite biased with St. Charles, but I'd like you to look into his life and we realize that money can be a way to holiness. Wealth can be our path to service and charity. It need not blind us to the needs of the people around us. May we be like St. Charles in humility, and may all that we do become a work of love. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Thank you for being with us in our celebration Also to our online parishioners, salamat sa pagdarasal kasama namin. Patuloy po natin isama sa panalangin ng mga minamahal na yumao. And through the inspiration of St. Charles Borromeo, may we do everything, our work as work of love. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.